Hi, welcome back to CoSpark's channel and back to the tutorial for artificial intelligence. This is an exclusive tutorial for who are preparing for the UGC NET and some of the competitive as well as the college level exams. Let's go for session today. Today's session we are going to see the topic called algorithm called best first search algorithm. This is one of the informed search algorithm. Another name you can say greedy search algorithm. In the previous session I explained about the generate and test algorithm and the procedure. I hope that you understand. Let's cover session today. So this algorithm, we are going to see the part one, that is what and what are the steps involved in this algorithm and advantages as well as the disadvantages. So best first search algorithm, so one of the easy and important algorithm where it always select the path which appears best at that moment. So if you want to reach the goal node, it always helpful to select which node want and which is the shortest path, and we can fix the path also later. Then it's a combination of DFS and BFS, that is breadth first search and depth first search. This algorithm already explained, you can check in the playlist, and it's one of the informed search algorithm. Then and also it always uses the heuristic function h of n less than equal to h multiply star n, and where h of n is called what? Heuristic cost, and the h star of n is called estimated cost. And also the greedy best first algorithm is implemented by the priority queue. Then go for algorithm. Let's cover the steps involved in the algorithm. Step number one, place the starting node into the open list. And step number two, if the open list empty, and stop and return failure. So remember, whenever best first search algorithm, to find the solution for the given problem, you have to consider two types of list. One is called open and one is called closed one. So first one, open list. Here let's assume that you have a node S and the successor node A and B, and the heuristic value of A is 4 and B is 2. How do you understand now? See, place the starting node, that is the open node. You can if you want start, you can start with the initialization node S like that. Then if the open list is empty, stop and return failure. And step number 3, remove the node N from the open list which has lowest value of H of N and places it in the closed list. So let's assume that our target node is somewhere, and we have started the process here. So first start with open A and close S, and close in the close node I am keeping B. Why? Because this out of this success node, which is having least heuristic value, that's B. So which having highest, that we should be in the keep in the open list. So open A, and because A having 4 and B having 2, so I open A and close, I'm keeping S comma B. This is the it's a small example, you understanding purpose. So you can confirm and we can fix the path. S comma B is the path where find the solution for the given problem. Then step number 4, expand the node N and generate the success of node N. So if you want, you can extend here B C D with B C D. If C value heuristic value is 5 and D is heuristic value is 1, we can continue the close. That means what? So we can write S comma B comma D and A comma C, because same condition, which node having less heuristic value or lowest heuristic value, that should be in the close, and another one in the open mode, highest value in the open mode. Then step number 4, just now told you. Step number 5, check each success of node N and find whether the node is a goal node or not. And if success node is goal node, then return success and terminate the search. And so remember, so suppose you are keep on searching the node level 0, level 1, level 2, and suppose you are getting CD in the, you know, D is your, suppose you are D is your goal node, you are, can stop the process. If you achieved a goal node, means you can stop the process and terminate it. If not, then continue again. Then step number 6, for each successor node, algorithm checks for evaluation function of called f of n, and check if the node has been in either open or closed list. If the node has not been in both lists, then add it in the open list. Then step number 7, return to step number 2. So these are the steps in the algorithm of best first search. So upcoming, this is a part 1 video. Upcoming session I definitely explain the algorithm with BFS with this very simple example and how to implement. So there you can get clarity. So best to understand the points here, open and close, both listing part in the algorithm of BFS, and also it's a combination of TFS and the BFS. Let's look for advantages and disadvantages. The advantages, you can say these are the algorithm can switch between BFS and DFS by gaining the advantage of both algorithm, and also this algorithm is more efficient than BFS and DFS. So upcoming system raises the example how to find the or select the path for the path and how to achieve the solution for the given problem. There you can get clarity. And disorders also there, it can stuck in a loop as a DFS and is not optimal because and also this algorithm is not an optimal, it can stuck in loop versus DFS. Means what? As worst case scenario, some of the problems you can solve. But worst case scenario, just you know the DFS what happened, you go and check all the levels, level 0, level 1, level 2, and backtracking and so on. So here also some of the drawbacks. Sometimes we can't get the solution properly. So if whenever you got the solution, the meaning is what? It's not optimal. But most of the solutions we try to get the output with the solution with the help of this BFS, the best one, and also one of the informed search. These are about BFS algorithm first part. And if you have any queries, suggestions, please communicate with us on social media. And thanks for watching. Please like, share, comment, subscribe, press bell icon for more updates, and please support our channel. Thanks.